Astro Boy Omega Factor. It's a game where you set your spacing umbrella self over asteroids and meteor bites of exploding exploration and plain acting fun. This game has an overall challenge factor. I mean, it is very challenging. And I'm not just saying it, just like trying to piss on Ice Cube without even missing the target. That's how hard this touching, angling game is compared to other treasure games. That bosses have a hit point, as always, in Konami Treasures, but they will also have a hidden pattern. What I mean is, that is a little bit more confusing than others, in a way. Like close to the end, you're going to have to watch your eyesights from being previously torn by these awful burrito enemies. I mean, I almost broke my computer desk by slamming my powdering fist on this sucker. I mean, yes, if you want an easy game, stick with Nintendo dogs. This is very hard and very noble and wise for the old school video game players. The story is Astro Boy. From the original Skilling cartoon show, we sat around in a comfort zone, and this is for all the different meaning old school baby fanboys that actually watched the TV show. It has a similar meaning as Mega Man. It may have a different construction or destruction to a lot of other robot games, but they have a little Japanese humor that Capcom actually didn't use. Capcom was a serious plotline for Mega Man, but sometimes this could be humorous and it could be out of an anime comic book. Hate to stress you out and no more details, but overall Astro Boy is wondering, what is past? How did he get made into a robot? Where was he from? Stuff like this will keep you entertained, precisely. The gameplay is punching, lock in a fiery blue laser as it shoots for the housing babies and enemy territories as a death threat. This game has a fighting game similar to Double Dragon, but the Contra look to it. I mean, it's a space replica as well, but it has a fighting Double Dragon style which you will have to use in order to capable to play the game really well. The lasers don't work all the time. You have a green meter with a valuable hit mark. So if you get hit so much, your meter goes down. And the only reason how you get it up is fight more enemies by your static punching. You can also upgrade your laser hit life, just like how your RPG works in some similar way. The bosses are very creative, and some will poke your eyes out as the Konami sketches most of their demented work in our minds. Very creative background look tendously great, and I mean the first is the features of cars flying around, and some other details as oceans, ice, lands, fire, Egyptian cool, towering looks from near heights and below. The art is amazing for a Game Boy Advance classic, so it really takes you out and then rather getting pissed off like a cock slashing baby like me. Conclusion. I enjoy this game. The music is fine with some catchy tracks. I wouldn't say it's Double Dragon with a good charm with it, but it has a space charm as well. It might not be two-player, and it might not be multiplayer, but it is a game for your GBA collection. I'd rather take my prize than playing the old NES Classic 50 times in boredom. So please check this game, and I'll give it a 9.5 out of 10.